Thank you.
Thank you.
Does Allison have anything to do with Allentown?
And you can call me, by the way.
By
the way, everybody apparently has more than one name when they come down here.
My name is Buck.
Okay, Alan. So, we know Kip's going to do a good job.
It's going to be working.
And what's your name?
No, oh, it's Ben. Back to me.
How you doing?
Ben.
I don't like that.
His name is Ben.
I can't pronounce that.
Sorry. Come on. Natural. Tell me about your summer boat trip.
I'm sweating now.
Remember about that flounder? It was this big.
I have something about live action photos don't work. Not repairing ball marks on the grill.
Brother from Seattle, Washington. It's actually Edmonds.
From Seattle. His name is
Edmonds, Seattle.
John Skeppy.
Mark CLU, CHFC. Tell us a little bit about yourself, son.
No.
Not interested. Not candid.
I'm from Seattle. That's all you
are his brother, though.
Go Hawks, go.
Otherwise, I'm just working for the government.
Go Hawks, go. Cousin Skippy from way back. He's obviously got tears in his eyes. Cinderella boy.
Big moment.
Big moment.
Also go with by what are the names? Who's going to go by?
James Early Barr, the third or fourth.
Fireboy.
Thank you. Charles Catania, I'm sure you're familiar with his work.
All the publications.
Produced several underground films. I made all the major post offices.
We would move for submissions in the next area.
Wayne.
Of course, retribution later.
Wayne is my brother-in-law to be, and he's just a fabulous dresser, good dancer.
It's good to be in America.
Singer.
It's good to be in America. And
Birmingham.
It's important to have him, because I didn't think he was going to get out of that circle.
Did your dog ever get over that fort?
No, my dog is going to be better, though. Thank you.
Tantle, tantle, tantle.
I don't know what that means. Sorry, I didn't introduce Tom. He's obviously the most well-to-do gentleman here in the Tri-County area.
I just want to have it on the record that this is the last of your weddings that I'll ever go to.
Ever.
So this better be it.
You better be a good man here.
That's it.
And try to pay attention to what you do.
Yes, sir.
We went to do go-karts today, go-karts, and we did some driving range.
Set by the pool time.
That was pretty much it. Yeah. All right, now back to the pants in the audience.
Any Tampa Nuggets today?
Tampa Nuggets. Yeah, he had a couple of those.
That's Mark. I knew.
I'll look at him in the mirror and fix him up.
Okay, hang on here.
Y'all can come and do this every day.
Really?
Can you imagine you have somebody dress you every day?
I can handle it.
Nice. I'll get it.
Just pull them out.
We have too many.
So what if I'm missing a few? It doesn't matter.
Well, I mean, think about me though. That'll be good. Look great. I'm already painting.
On to the shoes. There's that little hook. Oh, good. I do have a hook for the. Have a hook to carry them
on
to.
Yeah. Right there. So. Yeah. Underneath.
Okay.
Right there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. There you go. Yeah. Yeah, I didn't even know that. I just found it.
I'll just carry it like this for now.
Okay.
Well, I got you. You're okay.
Of course.
You're going to have to
carry
it. Okay.
Okay.
What's that?
Oh.
Yeah, well, do we all have to put the Vaseline on our lips?
I'm just picking on this month.
We all need to do it.
So I have all the
old is my body.
Where'd you buy those from, honey? I borrowed them from Linda's friend.
Oh, really?
Linda's friend.
You know her.
They're borrowed.
Close.
I borrowed.
Linda's friend.
Well, she wore them in her wedding, and I told her, I said, oh, I like those earrings. I said, oh, maybe I could borrow this.
Don't go anywhere, Peppy, because I'm attached.
Here, we can fold it up.
I can sit down if we move it over the chair.
Okay.
And so just brush down. And you have to move the whole back. We're
Penny,
moving.
Did you get your penny in your shoe?
Yeah.
Did you get
you
a picture?
Did you want to see all the stuff
we're yeah.
Old.
Here you go.
Her body.
Let me see. Check these so, babes out.
Yeah. Okay, here's this one. Right?
Here's the penny. Mom, you want to put the penny in?
Yeah.
The penny?
What's the penny?
Good luck. See?
And you think I'm like
getting control with these super shoes. You would think by now you'd need like a dollar in your shoe.
Inflation is still going up.
The sixpence in the shoe.
For good luck. Lots of good luck, darling.
Thanks, Mom. Here we go.
We won't get lipstick.
The kiss, not
yeah, really, the air kiss.
Right.
We'll do lots okay. of those.
Am I looped over?
You're all set. Yeah,
I can sit?
Yeah, can sit. Park it.
Where's the chair?
Yeah, really, don't miss the chair.
I almost missed
okay,
it.
Can I just kind of drag this?
Can I just
I'm
drag
going
this?
Down.
I'll just drag this.
Perfect. Okay. Am I okay?
We get out of your way here.
Get out of some here.
They're going to do Tic Tacs.
In the trash?
No. Sorry, did I get in your way?
Hold on.
I feel like I've got Halo head. You know, like, are we taking these things off of our head?
Pam, are we taking these off?
I'm going to need to leave my own because I'm going to have the counterpart hat head. Nance, a couple of questions.
Oh, y'all can do whichever.
Okay. But me, I'm gonna be swinging.
Don't take them. Don't take them off until after Mike and I have our dance. Because make sure at the reception. Once we have the introductions, when y'all go out, line up against in front of the band. Okay. Line up in front of the band. Yeah. When line up in front of the band, because then Mike and I are gonna have our first dance.
When do we come in on?
And then the band will direct y'all to come in, or you can come in near the end if he forgets to do that. Okay. Before dinner, and come in before you'll dance with your partner that you're with today. Okay.
I hope he can dance.
I don't even know his name.
You're with Tom, sure.
Oh, Tom. Oh,
yeah.
Tom.
What is his name?
Yeah. Oh, okay. Tom. Hey, yeah. What song are you coming in?
We're doing Unforgettable.
Oh, good. Oh.
The storybook wedding.
Really? Is this like? And to think, our dear Pam.
I just have to think that would be sweet.
She's the princess.
Thank you, darling.
Just think
right.
How it all began. Oh, glad I didn't tell that story earlier. I figured my mother always said, good answer.
Somebody just hand me my bag. This coat, I'm forget to put my lipstick in. No, just the white one.
The white
evening bag. The white purse.
Teresa, I have a hard time passing.
Ann, are your shoes all right?
Are you carrying that bag down the aisle?
I've never went for shoes there.
She's not carrying that issue.
Peppy, you carrying that bag down the aisle?
Yeah.
You are?
Are you?
How right it is. I guess we've always known that a day like this one would come, when our children would leave us and begin to build a home of their own. Lord, all you have taught us, we have gladly passed on. But one thing we don't know is how to place them back in your arms again. Lord, help us let go of two, that they might become one, just like the Father, Spirit, and Son. Two hearts invisibly bound in love by a vow that will not be undone. Now in your tender care, Lord, be all that we cannot be. And help us to trust you when we don't see you quickly meeting their needs. For you have provided since the day you gave our children to us. But now in your arms, dear Jesus, the time has come for giving them up. Lord, help us let go of two, that they might become one, just like the Father, Spirit, and Son. Two hearts invisibly bound in love by a vow that will not be undone. The urge is strong to try holding on to the image of two, the way that we knew them. But now in your eyes, the two will be as one. Help us let go of two, that they might become one, just like the Father, Spirit, and Son. Two hearts invisibly bound in love by a vow that will not be undone. Let go of two, that they might become one, just like the Father, Spirit, and Son. Two hearts invisibly bound in love by a vow that will not be undone. By a vow that will not be undone. By a vow that will not be undone.
Please be seated. Dearly beloved, we're gathered together here in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to join together Michael Scott Kipnis and Pamela Lann Morris in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God and signifying unto us the mystical union which exists between Christ and His holy church, which holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with His presence in Cana of Galilee. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, Mike and Pam come now to be joined. I require and charge you both, as you stand in the presence of God, before whom the secrets of all hearts are disclosed, that having duly considered the holy covenant you're about to make, you do now declare before this company your pledge of faith each to the other. Be well assured that if these solemn vows are kept inviolate, as God's word demands, and if steadfastly you endeavor to do the will of your heavenly Father, God will bless your marriage, will grant you fulfillment in it, and will establish your home in peace. Mike, wilt thou have Pam to be thy wedded wife, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all other, keep thee only unto her, so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Pam, wilt thou have Mike to be thy wedded husband, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all other, keep thee only unto him, so long as you both shall live?
I will.
When I meet with a bride and groom to go over the wedding ceremony, one of the things that is top of the list and very important is who will give the bride away. On the note that I have about the wedding today, it's still there. Bobby will give Pam away. We miss him, but what we know of Bobby, about his life and his love, he's here with us where he wants to be, and we're grateful for that. Who giveth Pam to be married to Mike?
Her mother and I.
In the third chapter of the book of Colossians, we find some very beautiful words to help us in entering into this wonderful state of matrimony. You are God's people. He loves you. He has chosen you for His very own. So then, you must clothe yourself with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Be tolerant with one another and forgive one another whenever there is cause for forgiveness. You must forgive one another just as Jesus Christ has forgiven you. And to all of the qualities, add love, which binds all things together in perfect unity. The peace that Christ gives us is to guide us in the decisions we make. For it is to this peace that God has called you two together into one body. And always be thankful. Forgiveness, love, thankfulness. The love that God has put in your heart for each other is the love that will bind you together when things go rough, when things go smooth. when things are difficult, when things are easy. In all of your life, remember that God is the one who put love in your heart for each other. And as I have told you, it takes three persons to make a good marriage: a woman and a man and God. Be sure you remember to put God in your marriage. And God bless you as you do. Will you please join right hands? Look at each other. Will you repeat after me, please? I might take you, Pam.
I might take you, Pam.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish till death us do part.
Love to cherish till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
I thereto pledge you my faith.
I thereto pledge you my faith.
Will you please say, I, Pam, take you, Mark.
I, Pam, take you, Mark.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish till death us do part.
To love and to cherish till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto I pledge you my faith.
And thereto I pledge you my faith.
You may turn now and face me. May I have a ring, please? The wedding ring is an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, which signifies the uniting of these two hearts in Christian love through the Church of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Let us pray. Our Father, we pray your blessings on these two Christian people as they exchange these rings. May they always wear them with honor and love, and may they bless their lives throughout all the years of their lives. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Take the smaller of that ring and put it on her ring finger, please, on the left hand. And repeat after me. In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of the vow between us made.
And the vow between us made.
With this ring I thee wed.
With this ring I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Take that and put it on his left hand. That's his left hand. In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of the vow between us made.
Of the vow between us made.
With this ring I thee wed.
With this ring I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. You may drop your hands.
Though I command languages both human and angelic, if I speak without love, I am no more than a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. And though I have the power of prophecy to penetrate all mysteries and knowledge, and though I have all the faith necessary to move mountains, if I am without love, I am nothing. Though I should give away to the poor all that I possess, and even give up my body to be burned, if I am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. Love is never jealous. Love is not boastful or conceited. It is never rude and never seeks its own advantage. It does not take offense or store up grievances. Love does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but finds its joy in the truth. It is always ready to make allowances, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love never comes to an end, but if there are prophecies, they will be done away with. If tongues, they will fall silent, and if knowledge, it will be done away with. For we know only imperfectly, and we prophesy imperfectly. But once perfection comes, all imperfect things will be done away with. When I was a child, I used to talk like a child, and see things as a child does, and think like a child. But now that I have become an adult, I have finished with all childish ways. Now we see only reflections in a mirror, mere riddles. But then we shall be seeing face to face. Now I can know only imperfectly. But then I shall know just as fully as I am myself known. As it is, these remain: faith, hope, and love. The three of them, and the greatest of them is love.
For as much as Mike and Pam have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and have therefore pledged their faith each to the other, and have declared this by joining hands and by giving and receiving rings, I pronounce that they are now husband and wife together, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And those whom God hath joined together, let no one put asunder.
Let us pray. O eternal God, creator and preserver of all humankind, giver of all spiritual grace, the author of everlasting life, send thy blessing upon Mike and Pam, whom we bless in thy name, that they may surely perform and keep the vow and covenant between them made, and may ever remain in perfect love and peace together, and live according to thy laws. Look graciously upon them, that they may love, honor, and cherish each other, and so live together in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and true godliness, that their home may be a haven of blessing and a place of peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please join us in praying the Lord's Prayer. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thy name.
God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord graciously with his favor look upon you and so fill you with all spiritual benediction and love that you may so live together in this life that in the world to come you may have life everlasting. Amen. You may kiss the bride. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Michael Scott Kipnis.
That's right. Okay.
All the way.
Up.
And then. I think it's you.
It is?
Yes. Turn.
Yeah, that's
and then
right.
Come back this way.
Okay.
One down.
One down.
I'm
best. Go straight back.
My act is keeping a good up close eye on him.
She has sat in my lap.
That's right. I sure have. Wait, come here. You know me, I don't frown.
There he is, girl.
Lynn?
Yes, right here.
Oh,
excuse me,
girl.
Or
not.
I don't know.
Oh,
just
okay.
Anyone that
order.
Come
on,
Nate. That's gotta get on video. Oh, well, you missed it.
I love it.
It's okay. No action photos. She missed the whole thing. Typical. Video.
Yeah. You want me.
I'll catch you when you need to.
That's
right. Oh, gosh. So sweet.
Pam, you did great.
Yeah.
And so did Mike. Michael, you look very strong. Yes. Yes. I will.
Really good.
And you know what? You were really serious through the whole thing.
That's just an uncle mom.
You listen. So you better do it. Love, honor, cherish, forgive by presents every day. Flowers.
Your husband.
You're married now. Get out.
My hubby.
What? Is they're boring now?
No.
That too. All married. Got a little outfit.
We're so glad we
got 2 hours. I'll be having dessert and going to Italy.
Tell your mom.
Mom, this way. Okay.
Hello there.
This is Gil Brady. He's in charge.
Well, just stay down here. This is one we get to show off.
Moms are in charge.
Very good. Fantastic.
Nice leaving. You noticed that?
Yeah.
Where's the flower? Where's your flowers? Up or down? Flower up or down? Flower up or down?
There it is.
Suzanne.
I'm sorry.
Where you go, Suzanne Stabler?
We'll frame your pictures with Suzanne.
Yeah.
There we go.
Oh, good.
Another spot.
No, you know what?
That's it. One more. This is the best one. It's third time's the charm. One, two, Mike's ready. Three. There you go. All right.
I gotta go.
There, I'm gonna get some more over at the reception. Bunches more.
Okay, good. Right.
Okay.
Thank you.
Great.
Oh boy.
Special people, the wedding party, couple number one, Mrs. Nancy Mason and Mr. Charles Catania. Give them a hand, please. Lovely couple, Nancy and Charles.
Thank you.
sight or first dance?
Now a special dance for the bride and groom. A moment that is, that was a poignant moment, wasn't it? A moment that is unforgettable.
Very special people, to I'm sure all of us, and certainly myself and my wife, and my family, him and Mike. I've known Mike quite a good bit of time, and I love him like a brother. I trust him. I'm delighted that we're here, and I wish that Pam will become part of our family as well. We love her. All the best. Suzanne, the Matron of Honor, would also like to say a word.
It's hard for me to say just a word, so bear with me. Pam, for those of you that don't know me, Pam and I were college roommates, and we have a lot in common. And I'm really, really excited for her and what's going on in her life. I was just going to tell you a few things that we share in common that are kind of odd. When we first started in college, we met each other. We pledged the same sorority, and we were on pledge retreat. We're the only two that came to college without a boyfriend. That was how we first bonded, because we were the ones that had nobody. And then the next year, we decided that we were going to be college roommates. And so over the summer, we were looking for our comforters, because you know it's important that your comforters match. So I said, oh, Peppy, I found some comforters on sale, and I think I'm going to get them. And she said, oh, my gosh, I already bought some sheets. She said, I've sent the sheets to you. And I was like, oh, well, maybe it'll all, you know, at least it'll coordinate, because we decided that we were interested in burgundy. The sheets that she sent me, no, this is true. The sheets that she sent me were identical to the comforter that I picked out. Then, when we went to Europe after we graduated, we both decided that we should take one nice dress for our travels. We ended up with the exact same color dress. It was like this all the time. And the culminating point of our relationship, and I shared this with the bridesmaids, was when we were in the room and I wanted to sleep and she needed to stay up and study. And so I snuggled under my covers and Peppy said, what are you doing, getting into your little igloo? And I threw back the covers and I said, Pep, I was thinking the exact same thing. Now that's weird. We have a lot of closeness. The final thing that's close to us is that both of our husbands are named Michael Scott. I know she copies me a lot. Anyway, I would like to say that Pam, I have shared a lot of joys with you, a lot of sorrows, and I am thrilled with your choice of a husband, and I just welcome you to our family as well.
Hear, hear.
I would like to just say a couple words on behalf of our family, and first of all, express our appreciation for each one of you being here. We certainly are thankful that we have so many friends that would come and support us and be so kind and caring for our family. And especially over the past month, couple months, and the events that have happened, we have certainly felt a lot of love and expressions of care, which we are very thankful and gracious and grateful for. On behalf of my dad, my mom, myself, my wife, I would like to welcome Mike into our family. I've grown to know and love Mike, especially over the past couple of months, and he has been so loving and caring to our family, and I want to thank him for that. And also I want to congratulate my sister, even though when we were about 3 or 4 years old, or 5 or 6, she stuck a pencil in the top of my head. I still remember that. So if I ever get my chance to repay her, I might, but no, to her, I'm very, very happy for her selection of her husband and for their relationship and for their love for each other. And so to them, I wish them the best and God's blessing.
This recording to his daughter, Jimmy Dean's monologue to a sleeping beauty. Enjoy your dinner.
Dear daughter, I tiptoed in your room tonight, and I looked down at you smiling in your sleep. You were so lovely, my heart nearly broke. And I thought, how very much like sleeping beauty. a secret that I've never told you, Sleeping Beauty. You're going on a very exciting trip. You'll travel from yesterday all the way to tomorrow. It's a rapid journey, and you'll travel light, leaving behind you measles, mumps, freckles, bumps, bubblegum, and me. I promise not to feel too hurt when you discover that the world is more important than your daddy's lap. Yesterday you were blue jean and pigtail, the neighborhood's best tree climber. Tomorrow you'll be blue orange and ponytail, and you'll view the world from a loftier perch, a pair of high-heeled shoes. Yesterday you mend the dog's broken leg with a hug. Tomorrow you'll be able to break a young man's heart with a kiss. Yesterday you could get lost one aisle away from me in the supermarket. Now I have to worry about losing you down another aisle to some strange young man. You see, just at the point where your growing pains stop, mine begin. Yesterday you were kind of a pain in the neck when you were around. Tomorrow you'll be an ache in my heart when you're not. Tomorrow you'll lay aside your jump rope and tie up the telephone lines. And that little boy that used to push you in the mud, well, he'll fight to sit out a dance with you. The clock upstairs is counting the minutes for you. The sky upstairs is saving its brightest stars. And the sun is waiting with its shiniest days. Oh, I can't expect you to live in a dollhouse forever. Sooner or later, the butterfly sheds its cocoon, and the smallest bird must try its wings. But when you grow up and out of my arms, when you finally get too big for my shirts, I'll still recall how you used to scatter dust and dolls impartially through every room in the house. But you spread sunshine, too. The dust is settled. Your mom picked up the dogs. But the sunshine will always fill the corners of our hearts. So, here I am, talking in your sleep. Because, well, if you saw this look on my face, you'd laugh. And if I spoke with this lump in my throat, I'd cry. Yeah, honey, when I looked at you tonight, you were a sleeping beauty. So I tiptoed over and I kissed you. You didn't wake up. I knew you wouldn't. According to the legend, only the handsome young prince can open your eyes. And I'm just the father of the future bride. So you sleep on, pretty thing. Tomorrow you'll wake and you'll be a young lady. And you won't even realize that you've changed courses in the middle of a dream. But you might notice a little change in me. I look a little different somehow. A little sadder, a little wiser, but a whole lot richer. Tonight, I kiss the princess, and I feel like a king.
Well, I'm
tank, and before too long, I fell in love with you. I'll never live without her. Since I saw her dancing.
Okay.
Okay.
KC.
We'll do the KCK.
A great life together as well as a great honeymoon. This is how you kiss, by the way.
Right.
That's the way it's done. Longer, maybe more involved. But go KC. So,
happy honeymoon.
See ya.
Pam, hey babe. I just want to congratulate you and Mike and wish you just the many, many happiest of years. And I really miss you guys and hope to be able to visit and save me a spot. You don't have to be so nice.
Hi, Pammy. You're in my neighbor now, so I think that's really cool. You're like the crosstown bus right away. So I'm looking forward to that. And I'm really looking forward to wearing that dress at my wedding. So please, like, don't mess it up tonight.
Hey, Mike, all I have to say is you owe Eddie and I $100 each because you bet us that we wouldn't get our butts down here to Alabama to your wedding, and we're here, so we want to know when our $100 is coming in the mail to Connecticut. Love you both. Bye.
Hi, Pam and Mike. This is Marsha Levine. Hi. I hope I meet a guy as nice as you, Mike. I'm looking hard, but thank you for my wonderful day tonight. Mike.
Mike, I know you went to Lehigh and went to the University of New Hampshire, and we beat your butts every time we played you. And about Kansas City, I think the Atlanta Falcons are a little bit better than Kansas City. I want to most of all thank you for my date. It was the greatest date ever at a wedding. I'll tell you what, phenomenal. Pam, it was great. Mike, nice to meet you. And best of luck going forward in your marriage. Bye.
Keep it clean and keep it fair. They good songs.
one story I did not want to tell in front of a large crowd was that Mike Kipper really does not like to sleep in a bed. He prefers a small piece of carpet near the front door of any home. And if the carpet's damp, well, all the better. And so, Pam, when you're thinking about how to make him happy, get him a small piece of carpet, get it wet, get it near the front door, you'd be all set.
I just want to say congratulations.
Say something more than congratulations. He eats all the peanuts anywhere he is.
I'll tell a little story I couldn't tell last night at the rehearsal dinner about how Mike Kipnis decided that he wanted to run for, I think it was junior class president, maybe sophomore class president at Lehigh. And he ran on a platform that two heads are better than one, with a mannequin head on his shoulder and his on his poster. And the mannequin head was actually that of Joseph from the Nativity scene. That's a little known fact, but I was there when he stole it. It was about 9 feet high, couldn't fit in the car back to Lehigh, so he just took the head. And that's just one of those things I couldn't tell if I was mother or one of them. Good luck, Mike and Pam. We wish you a lot of luck and happiness.
Mike and Pam, thanks so much for having us here tonight. It was great to be part of your day. And we both wish you much love and happiness forever.
Okay, Tom, you're on.
Let's see now. I'm trying to see. Kip, what is this for? Like telling stories about Kip? Well, this is Kim Sheridan, the lovely Kim Sheridan, Kim Sheridan.
Hi.
That's enough. Let's see, about Kipper. Well, Kip, as you start marriage, let me just remind you that it's like a hot bath. Once you've been in for a long time, it's not so hot. No, I'm sure you and Pam are going to have a great time together. We are very happy to be down here in Huntsville. I know you don't like that analogy. I think it was something else. Very happy to be down here in Huntsville, Alabama. We're having a great time here. Sure, marriage is great, particularly if you have Lyme disease. Really, 3 years with that is just spectacular. Let me tell you about a couple of antibiotics, a couple of times in the hospital, allergic reactions. It's great. Start with that and you'll be great from there on. I'm like it. Marriage is a great institution. Institution is a good word for marriage, actually. I like to say I've been down here with my friend Ben.
Ben,
here in Alabama. Yeah, my wife's about to kill me now.
Okay, very good.
I would just like to say to Pam and Kipper that we hope we get to spend a lot more time with you than we have already. Kip, I promise I won't make you move me anymore. That's the last time I'll make you do that. And I hope you have a great time in Greece and Italy, and that the Chiefs go at least 10-6, maybe 11-5 with Joe Montana. Who's next? Ben? Ben? Come on, Ben.
Come on.
Come on,
Turn around,
Bonds.
Whoa.
He's like demanding, that. Isn't he?
She's got this thing in the face.
Show the face.
Just so you know what I'm talking about.
It's going to be on more video than anything.
Andrew got involved with Freddie.
We just want to tell you a little story about the night that Kipper and Pam met, because it was the night of our rehearsal dinner, right?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And we went to a bar afterwards.
Tucson's.
Very unusual for us.
A bar, a restaurant.
We were lounging, but it was not the Boxing Cat. It's good.
No, it was Tucson's. It was Tucson's. The t-shirt that Kipper had on just yesterday, by the way.
At any rate. He met Pam that night. She was there with friends. And
Nancy and Kim Kiner.
Thank you very much.
Yes.
And he ended up staying there very late with her. Obviously, they hit it off right away, and they had a really good time. And
as far as we've heard,
most of us left because we were pretty in the bag at that point. And Kip decided to stay and hang out for a little while, see what would happen. And Pam offered him a ride home. Everyone else had left. Kipper had no way to get home, but he was too embarrassed to say that he had no car, so he said, no problem, I'll get home, whatever. He ended up walking home, trying to walk home to Chaz's house, which is about 5 or 6 miles away. He got about halfway home, and we had given him silk pajama bottoms as his,
for
the usher present. And he put them on over the pants that he was wearing and ended up sleeping in some corridor of a house that he crawled into on the way, which was perfect for him at the time. Woke up the next day, and ended up meeting Pam later on that weekend, and here we are now. Isn't that a beautiful story?
That's a beautiful story.
Added part of this is Sunday we had a brunch afterwards, and Kipper came up to us and told us that he could only be there.
Nice.
Yeah, it's a nice touch. That he could only be there for an hour.
Sometimes I get these urges.
He could only be there for an hour because he was driving a woman that he met to the airport. And Ben and I looked at each other and were like, what do you mean?
What do you mean by that?
You just met this woman on Friday night. On Friday night, and on Sunday, you drive her to the airport. And we looked at each other like, this sounds really serious. And that was
it. He was working it.
Okay,
Walter,
you're up.
All right. Congratulations.
Congratulations. We love you guys both. Thanks a lot. Have a good time. Yes.
All right. Come on. Come on. You have to hold it for Vaughn.
Vaughn, you need help?
No, I think I've got the camera.
Help her out.
Okay, Kip. This is a, got it? Okay. Yeah, okay.
Do some photo.
This is a quick dating history. Just kind of put Kipper in perspective for Pam and for his own personality. Here we have Pam to start with. Okay, great fashion sense. Here we have Kipper, not quite as much fashion sense, but he's teachable.
Teachable.
I want us to kind of focus on Kipper while I give a quick history of Pam's dating life. Now, Kipper, the first one that we had in college was Steve Polyester. He had hair parted down the middle, polyester pants that were tight in all the wrong places, and he was really, really queer. So we dumped him and we moved on to Wags. Pam, remember Wags? Dave Wags. Ask her, Kipper, about their sex life. It was really uproarious. Frightening. Then we went to Darren Norman, another personality plus, not a fashion plus guy. Didn't have good fashion sense. We had to shed Darren really quickly. And then we moved on to, there was one more.
Jimmy
High Cat Former, our senior year, Pam. We'll just not talk about the football player. I can't even remember his name. It's just too painful. But Kipper, it just really goes to show that even with your lack of fashion sense, you really won out. And as much as you get on my nerves, I'm really happy you married my friend because you're way ahead of the rest of them. So, greatest wishes and good luck. Bye.
All right, Mom. Yeah. All right, Suzanne. All right, wait, Sweat's up.
You go.
I just wanted to talk so that Vaughn would still look as tall as she did when she was on the... at the altar. But anyway, seriously, thanks for having us here. I know they wanted me to play saxophone tonight, but the only two songs I know are Misty and Taps. They already played Misty, and Taps might not be appropriate. But really, thanks for inviting us here. The ceremony was lovely. Vaughn, I didn't mean to pick on you. I really enjoyed your singing. And Wayne was all, where's Wayne? Wayne was also excellent with his singing, and the duet was especially nice. Leslie would have enjoyed that ceremony. You know, this is the fourth of five weddings I have in the last 6 weeks. And Leslie's sorry that she can't be here. But this wedding was really, seriously, was enjoyable. I noticed that there were 8 different states represented in your party here of best man and bridegroom. I was really excited about that, as well as the 15 different cities that were involved. Take a look at that handout from the wedding. There was 8 states and 15 cities in addition to everyone else that was here. Yeah, go ahead. You want to take a look at that right there, too?
What state is that now?
Huntsville, Connecticut.
Keep it working.
You got Alabama, you got Washington, Florida, things like that.
It's that great state of Huntsville. Where is that
Your best
state?
Man, Scott, got up there. He talked about family and bonding and such like that. And Suzanne, who was the maid of matron of honor, whatever that's called, got up there and talked about commonalities. And she shared a nice story about commonalities. Well, I have news for you. Put both of those together. You have a lot in common now, and you have a lot of friends now. And this people that are here are your new family, your new circle of friends, and we're going to be here with you from here for the rest of your life and consider your friends. Congratulations and good luck.
I really can't add to that.
But I'll try.
Kevin, Kevin, I just have to say that I think that Mike is a big step up from your last one who used to wear Sansa belts. Polyester Sansa belts. And so even though Mike wears a lot of Kansas City stuff, I think it'll be okay. You can work with him on that. And I just wanted to say just something that only you're going to really understand, but you'll remember the guy when we were in Europe that said, Pamela, your lips, I love you. Oh, my God, I love her. Okay, now you just remember that and laugh and try to explain that story to Mike.
Pam and Kipper, how are you? This has been a great evening, and certainly I've known
Pam forever, and Kipper, now I'm your friend too, which we know is a big deal, and I hope this was the most fun you've had in a long time and only the beginning of much more fun. So I love you both, and I am so glad I was here, and I'll see you soon. Bye.
Hey-o, hey-o.
Excuse me, I'd like to...
Ma'am.
Yeah, sorry.